हाय, माय नेम इज़ करवार, उदय करवार, एंड आई एम कॉलिंग यू फ्रॉम द ऑस्टोमी एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडिया। व्हाट इज ऑस्टोमी? दिस मस्ट बी इन योर माइंड। वेल, ऑस्टोमी इज अ सर्जरी दैट इज परफॉर्म्ड व्हेन एवर अ पेशेंट सफर्स फ्रॉम ब्लैडर कैंसर, कोलोन कैंसर और आईबीडी। इन दिस सर्जरी दे मेक एन ओपनिंग इन द एब्डोमेन टू ब्रिंग आउट द बॉडी वेस्ट। सो ब्लैडर कैंसर पेशेंट विल हैव यूरिन कमिंग आउट ऑफ दिस opening. For the colon cancer patient, stools will come out of this opening, and for the IBD patient, you'll have the digestive juices coming out. This opening is known as a stoma. So normally an ostomy patient is known as an ostomate across the world. Life is not very easy for an ostomate. He has to take care of his stoma for the rest of his life. Yes, the surgery makes him live longer and he can have a quality of life, but he needs to take care of a lot of things. He needs to take care of the stoma. Now, the stoma needs to have a bag attached externally on the body to collect all the body waste, whether it is urine, stools or digestive juices. And these bags need to be changed every week. These bags cost something like 900 rupees plus GST. No doubt, looking at the financial impact, most of the patients from the smaller towns and villages prefer death rather than going for the surgery and a lifetime of expense. We have approached the government and requested them to waive off the GST and the customs duty on these bags. Both of them put together work out around 25%, a sizable chunk. In fact, there is a recommendation from the government of Maharashtra to the GST Council asking for waiver. Unfortunately, this letter has been lying with the GST Council for the past 4 years. That's right, 4 years. It's very unfortunate that the officers handling this are not sensitized to such matters. We have also requested the government to include this ostomy appliances as a part of essential medication or medical devices. We have also asked the doctors to certify that the surgery creates a disability for life, and they have. We have approached the government to include the ostomates into the list of disabled people. Incontinence, uncontrollable incontinence, uncontrollable waste products coming out of the body, urine, stools, digestive juices, or a combination of all, is what the patient suffers from. And incontinence is a word that already exists in the list of disabilities. Only thing is, it is linked to neurological disorder. We have requested the government to insert the word ostomy. It will make all the difference. But there has been no response. We have been following up and following up and following up and following up and following up, but no response, and we are still following up. Our sincere request to the government is, please don't treat ostomy as a medical condition. It is not. Ostomy is a severe liability. In fact, I'm sorry, it's not a liability, it's a disability. It's a severe disability. And we have recommendations from the Tata Memorial Hospital. We have recommendation from AIIMS Raipur, TMC Calcutta, from the Association Surgeons of India, from the Colorectal Association Surgeons of India, from the Urological Society of India, among many others. So there is medical validation for our request. And all the doctors we have talked to have readily agreed to certify that yes, ostomy is leading to a disability and it makes a person disabled for life. My sincere request to the government is, please treat this as one and act before it's too late, sir. Last year we had 1,12,000 ostomy-related patients. This is not our data, sir. This is Globocan. India 2020, indicating 112,000 patients related to ostomy. Sir, please act before it's too late. Jai Hind.